This video is part of my Sims 2 Ultimate Visual and Gameplay Guide. I will have a link to the full video down below, but per my subscriber's request, I'm also uploading the video in part, so make sure you check out the playlist. Don't forget to back up your game first before attempting anything in this video. And remember, not everything you see is achievable because of different screen dimensions, editing, rendering, and PC specs. An honor roll program that I haven't mentioned before, SimPE. I use SimPE for this and that for a bunch of things, but at the moment, I only use it to export Sims and to change memories. Let me show you how I do that. This isn't exactly a tutorial in The Sims 2, but this is a tutorial that I think will definitely help you out with your gameplay. If you don't know how to use SimPE, I just want to put a quick disclaimer right here and say that I'm not going to show you how to use or install SimPE in this video. I am only going to show you how to use this program to make your own family trees. To install SimPE, go over to your tools section and click on neighborhood. First, we're going into neighborhood browser and we're going to select a neighborhood that has the Sims that we want to give a family tree. A bunch of neighborhoods in here, and for the sake of this video, I'm going to use a neighborhood that I don't really play in and that I know has a bunch of Sims. So I'm gonna go into my cast only world and load that baby up. So you want to wait for it to load first. On your left, you have a bunch of options and we want to click on family ties. I'll click again. Make the screen a little bigger so we're able to see what I'm doing a bit better. I clicked on the first household in the list. In this household, there are currently two Sims, but the Sims are not related. We have this guy called 66 and we got Q444. If this is the right Sim, I want to click on lock. Now, if you click on another Sim, the Sim in the picture will not disappear. Whereas if we unlock it and we click on Q, it will skip to her family tree. Better to lock the Sim before moving on. We're gonna start with 66. As I said before, I'm going to lock it. And underneath, you have a little section where it says the name of your Sim and the relationship. Cannot click on relation unless you select another Sim. Let's say 66 wants a sibling. After locking, right click on the other Sim and click on add. As long as you lock your Sim, you can change household folders and you can pick anyone you want to be added to the family. Right click on add. If you don't want your Sims to have a certain Sim in their family tree, click remove. Make sure to click commit. Using another Sim, let me show you once more. We're gonna lock her and we're gonna add these four people in her household. Let's add Karma. Let's add Sunflower and let's add Yay. This is my Cass household, so I don't usually care about the names, in case you're wondering. Karma is our parent and maybe Yay could be our crazy let's do child, and Sunflower can be our spouse. Once you're done, click commit. Since we added these Sims to her family tree, go to another Sim's family tree. The Sim in particular will also show up in their family tree, so you don't have to go over and do it a few times. Make sure to save the neighborhood before, you know, you leave. And if you did everything correctly, it should look a little like this. Let's take a look at their family tree. So these are the Sims that I used. So here's the family tree of Bay, and as you see, her mother is Karma. And then we have Bay with her spouse Sunflower, and Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Nana. Today I'm going to show you guys how I put my Sims up for download, how I change my Sims' personality, give them some extra traits, or change some basic things about them like their name way after I've created them in CAS. I will have a link in the description box where you can download that, and once you've done that, this is where we start at. Two things we are going to be doing is extracting and potentially changing, but we're not going to go into all the other options. These are just the two things I'm going to show you and two things that I know the best. You want to go into neighborhood and then click neighborhood browser, and then you want to go and select the neighborhood that you want or think you have a simen. I'm going to use my own world, which is this one, and I'm gonna go and open it. Say we want to go ahead and extract a sim. So you want to go into Sims Surgery and wait for that to load up to bring up this little menu that you can make as big as you want. Just pretend we're looking really hard to find something very specific. How about this girl? So what you want to do is click on the sim and then click patient sim, click on use, and then you can go ahead and export, and it will export as a sim package file that you simply put in your saved sims. So that is really all you do. If you've gone to neighborhood sim browser and double clicked on a sim of your liking, it'll bring up this little section. What you can do here is basically change anything. So we can change his name if we don't like that. We can give him a career, give him more than what is usually allowed for a lot of things. For example, we can set his career level, we can set his relationships, we can set his interests, we can also set his preferred gender, so we can literally just make him really attracted to both. Also put every character trait, every single one of them, everything into a 10 if you really wanted to, change the zodiac sign, give them some skills, romance, fatness, other ones, we can give them some flags. I wouldn't fuck around with this too much, honestly, but if you feel like you want to, you can obviously do that. These are some of the collectibles that you can get as well, free time. I mean, I'm not gonna really go through all of them, even though I just did. Basically, where I would change everything about my character if I don't want to do it in game or I really can't. There's obviously a lot more that this program has to offer. It also shows you kind of like who's with who, and you can also give people memories like this. There's a lot of things you can actually do, but those things I'm not really familiar with. Really aren't too many. Okay. Hello, Mr. Potato Head. There's lots of things you can do, but I don't really want to mess around with it too much because I haven't really done those things before.